And we are live. Oh my goodness. Gosh, I'm a little starstruck. I've got Trisha Turner, and I don't know how I got her on the show, but I'm so happy to have you here. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Hey, how's it going?
It's going really well. You know, you and I were just talking about the weather down in Houston, and I'm still not sure if I believe you that it's 40 degrees down there, because it's 40 degrees down here, but I mean, I guess winter is officially here, right?
Yeah, but we don't like it cold here, and there were snow flurries this morning, and we really don't like that. So, or I don't anyway. Other people were probably really happy, me not so much.
My guess is, though, you and your team do not slow down during the cold weather.
No, you can't. You know, no way. We got to hurry up because it's cold and we got to stay warm.
Yeah. Well, I am so fortunate to have you on the show, and I'm really excited to kind of dive into your EXP journey, your real estate journey. I always kind of start the show off with just laying the foundation for, you know, how you got into real estate. So I'll start off with that. Kind of fill our audience in on you know, when you got into real estate, how you got into real estate, and we'll talk to that for a minute, and then break into your transition here in just a moment.
Okie doke. Been in real estate a really long time. Got my license in 1992. So that was like decades ago, it seems, back when we still used key maps to show property and had pagers and crap.
Is that when you were 18?
Young. I know, isn't that crazy? I did real estate for years. I started off in property management, of course, then was in real estate sales for years. Fast forward a long time. My now ex-husband and I were a team together. He was also a real estate agent. I had a little boy born in the year 2000 that was and is medically challenged. And so one of us needed to pretty much be with him all of the time. Yeah. And so at that point, I was like, hey, I got to be more home-based with my work. So I actually was a loan officer for 6 years and put my real estate license inactive. My husband at that time was a real estate agent. So we had it going on, you know, for years. He was the real estate agent. I was the loan officer. It was awesome. Went through a divorce, and that was in 2006. And I decided I was gonna, at that point, I was still in lending. And then of course, in 2008, the mortgage crash came. Yeah. Single mom of three, one of them being a special needs child. I still tried to do lending until 2010. And it was just like losing deals left and right. You know, the banks weren't loaning to anybody. It was a really hard time. And I decided, you know what, I'm going back into real estate sales because I don't like this lending game anymore, especially as a solo person. And so went back into real estate sales full time in January of that year and been just, you know, kicking butt ever since. As a single mom, as I was for years, had to take care of my three kids and provide for them and be there for them. And so I've just been a hustler. I've hustled my whole life.
Yeah.
But I pretty much worked by myself independently. I've worked at every big box company out there. I started at Gary Green in 1992 and worked for this crazy broker. It's funny when I think back of it, she was a loon, you know, and not very supportive, more of just irritating and, you know, demanding, but not really supportive. And so kind of intimidated me then because I was really young. And so I've been at Keller Williams twice. I've been at Remax. I've been at Coldwell Banker. I've went through the gamut of all of them, you know, and through all of them. And then I was even at a 100% company because I wanted to just kind of try it all out because I knew eventually once my kids were old enough and teenagers and could kind of fend for themselves, I wanted to have my own thing going on. I've always been an entrepreneur. I've worked for myself forever. And so kind of watching how all of the real estate companies were run, franchises and such. You know, I never was a big believer in letting people take any of my money. I never was. I, you know, we work hard in real estate. We hustle. And there's a lot of companies out there, you know, Gary Green, all of them, they take a huge portion of your money. Some of the splits are 60-40, some are 70-30, you know, most are 80-20. Yeah. And so every time at the closing table, if I wasn't capped, I'm pissed off. You know, when I leave that closing table, I'm like, are you kidding me? You're not doing anything for me. I'm providing all my own stuff. I'm paying for all my own advertising. I'm training myself. I'm going to outside coaching stuff. And so I never liked that. That always irritated me. Yeah. And so that was always the end game, was for me to have my own company so I could give the people back their money and not take their money, but still be that source of support, still guide them. And so that's why I opened my own brokerage. And we opened 2 years ago, and we've been growing like crazy. You know, agents come here. I don't even recruit. They just come here on their own because we have a different culture here. We help each other. We support each other. And so I met Jay Kinder and Michael Reese, of course, in March of 2017. And again, I was just training myself. At that point, we were under construction in our build out here at my company. Yeah. And so I met them at one of their events, and it was, I think, how to be the go-to listing agent in your market. And of course, they're great presenters, and I was intrigued by them and attracted to them immediately for their skills, you know. And so found out they were the founders, of course, National Association of Expert Advisors. And I'm like, holy crap, I got to get involved in this. And so I did immediately. And so I've been with them since, you know, April of last year, and putting all their systems, processes, everything in place, using all of it, growing my business to, you know, great numbers, helping all the agents with me grow their business, but still running an independent brokerage, you know. And then last year, I see Jay and Michael move their independent brokerage over to EXP. And I had been approached by people at EXP before, honestly, you know, but I never was interested in it because it didn't weigh much merit on me. I didn't know very much about it. And, you know, me as a business owner and my own brokerage, it's like, no, you know, you're talking about a split. It's like, nope, we don't like those here. We are against them. And so when they moved over, I was like, I got to pay a little bit more attention to this, I think. And so naturally I'm watching all these big teams move over and these, you know, top producers come over and independent brokerages. And, you know, to make a long story short, I'm like, this is, as something, there's something going on here. And so Michael reached out to me. And again, I've been in coaching with them, so I'm heavily involved in everything that they do. And so anytime that they tap on my shoulder like, hey, we need you to look at something, I'm looking, because I mean, who doesn't want to do what they do? You know what I'm saying? And so Michael calls me and he's like, hey, we would like for you to come to Frisco and have a conversation with us. We like everything you have going on there at your brokerage, and we believe you have this, you know, we know you have the same core values that we do, but we think that you need to have a conversation with us and be part of this. And so we did. We went and I met them in Frisco, of course, and spent the day there with them talking with Jay and Michael. And they were explaining EXP to me and showing me the model. And it's an 80-20 split. Yeah, of course. And it's a 16,000 cap, but it's not like Keller Williams where you're paying for nothing. I mean, you know, yeah, Keller Williams, you're basically paying in $24,000 a year, but you're getting nothing. You don't own anything at Keller Williams. You're not getting trained. You're not getting anything. You still pay for your own marketing. You get nothing. You just get to say, I work at Keller Williams. Well, la-di-da. So, you know, immediately when they explain, yeah, you cap at 16,000, but once you've produced a certain amount of transactions, a certain number, you have the potential to have that stock awarded back to you. So it's an investment. It's an investment. And so for me, who's been paying for coaching and training and believe that real estate has got to be done professionally, ethically, I mean, you got to do an amazing thing for your clients. And for agents, when you have agents that you're trying to train and make them have an abundant life, you want to give them everything. You know, I do. I want to give them everything. And so when I talked to them and I saw the business model and I saw the way you create passive income and it's an agent-owned brokerage, how do you not want to be a part of that? You know, as an independent broker, yeah, I can give my agents their commission back to them minus in transaction fee. Absolutely. And I can train them all day long. But at the end of the day, can I provide them with technology like EXP can? Of course not. No way. When you put this many heavy hitters, you know, team leaders, independent brokers under one brokerage like EXP has done, you can't stop the madness. I mean, it's like an animal. Yeah. And for me, when you're an independent broker and owner and you're a producer too, all of that rolled into one, and you've got 50 agents with you, you know, you're being pulled at every angle. But at the same time, you're looking at this business model and you're like, oh my gosh, you guys have got to get a hold of this. I want to give you all of this that they have to offer, but we've got to go under the EXP brokerage or we can't do it, you know? And so it took a lot of talking, a lot of, just explaining, and because people have the mindset that it's an 80-20 split and it's just like Keller Williams, it's not. Mm-hmm. There's nothing like this. You're not going to see anything like this, you know? And for me to be able to have that kind of training for my agents, I mean, the technology is amazing. I saw it as a blessing, honestly. When Michael had that conversation with me, I was like, I left that meeting that day and I was like elated. And I thought, I'm a big believer and I believe that God puts his hand on people at the right time. And I was like, thank you, God. I don't know what I did to, you know, have that kind of favor, but it was one of those like moments when you're like, the hand of God just got put on me and was like, look, I'm going to take you and the agents that believe in you, and we're going to move you here and take you places where you've never been. And for me, I'm just thankful. I'm thankful and blessed extremely.
I love it. I love it. I love it. Love your passion, Tricia. It's just, it's infectious. I think there's a lot to unpack there, because I think oftentimes the myth in our industry is that when you've opened your own brokerage, you've essentially reached the pinnacle, right? And it can't get any better than that. And, and so what I heard you say is that, you know, while you bought into that for a while and you actually took action in opening your own brokerage, you did that for a few years, right? But then you were tapped on the shoulder and you were presented with an idea, and you were open-minded enough to do the research. And certainly Mike and Jay have some credibility, I would say, and some influence, most definitely, right?
Yeah, and definitely.
So that story wasn't hard to listen to. And so talk about when you first heard about it with your broker hat on, right? Because you're a broker, right? You can't get any better than that. You're a broker. Like you have your own brokerage. And
absolutely.
So it doesn't get any better than that. And these guys tap on your shoulder and they're like, hey, you know, come join this company. You know, it's got an 80-20 split. And I know you've mentioned before that your first thought was, oh my gosh, there's a split and we don't want to get back into that. But when you started to really unpack this, not only for you, but for all your people, why did it really make sense to you?
Okay, that's real easy to explain. Think of it like this. Okay, for most real estate agents, and this is just true, and you know, you hear these statistics, but until you're actually a broker running your own brokerage, you really don't see it when you're, you know, because now that I have been a broker and an owner, the average agent really does only sell 4 to 8 homes a year. That's the facts. I mean, they really are. And so when you see that, for me, it made me even the desire to help them was even greater, because I want them to do crazy numbers. I don't want people to have to live commission check to commission check. I want you to have money in the bank. I want you to be able to go on great vacations with your family. But so many average real estate agents, they're living commission check to commission check. Therefore, they don't have any savings. They don't have any means of creating passive income. They have that, you know, that great idea that when I make it, or when I am a big producer, I'll buy, you know, my first investment property. I'll buy a rental house. And then maybe in 5 years, I'll own 2 or 3. I mean, that there's no wealth in that. I mean, to create true wealth, you have to create passive income, a steady flow of passive income, not one rental house. But how the truth of the matter is, the average agent doesn't ever create enough income to get to buy that rental property because they're living check to check. What we have here under the EXP model is training, it's tools, it's systems, it's processes to help them go there, help them produce. Because when they're doing just this solo operation and thinking, you know, they're trying to protect their commission, 100% commission, that's all they care about. It's like, you're not investing anything in yourself. What are you giving back to invest in yourself? So the EXP model, it's collaborating with like-minded people. So for me, I do produce. So I don't live check to check, you know, thank the Lord for that. But I don't want any of my agents to live check to check. And so I train them. I am constantly training them, constantly. I'm there for them 24/7, and they know that. And I love that. However, with EXP, with the model that it is, it gives me the opportunity to collaborate with like-minded people like me, you know, because now I can have conversations with people in Ohio and Florida and Dallas, and we're all doing crazy numbers, and in California, and we're like, hey, how did you do this? You know, I was messaging with a guy this morning in Ohio, and I was like, oh my gosh, I saw something that he was doing. I hadn't thought of it. And so we were messaging back and forth at 7 o'clock this morning. We don't even know each other, but we're under the EXP brokerage together. He's another broker owner that moved over. And, you know, I would never be able to do that had I not moved over to eXp. As an independent broker owner here in Houston, Texas, I can't collaborate with anybody. Who am I going to collaborate with? They're all my competitors. They don't want to help me grow. I don't want to help them grow. I want my agents to grow and I want to grow. But the difference with eXp is we're all agent owned. It's a shareholders brokerage. Everybody owns some of it. So everybody wants everybody to be successful. I mean, I've never been a part of anything like this in all the years I've been in real estate. And like I said, I've worked at every big box company there is out there. I've never ever seen collaboration like this. I've never ever seen love and friendship and fellowship like I've seen ever in my career. And I couldn't have gotten here fast enough. And I wish I could touch more people, and I will, and get them to have a conversation and get them to see, because when you see that here in my office, I describe it as an army. I said, eXp is like an army of like-minded people that are out there. We are going to change the way real estate's done. We are going to make it more professional, more ethical. We're going to weed out those people that are closed-minded. We're going to weed out those people that are doing a disservice to the homeowner, because there's a lot of that going on. And you know what? It's okay that people are closed-minded and don't see it. That's fine. They can stay where they are. But for those of us that want to grow and make a difference in this world, there's not a better place to be.
Love it. So let's provide some context and share with our audience about, because this wasn't just you moving over. Like, you weren't just making a decision to move over, right? I mean, you were running an entire brokerage. So that in itself had to be a logistical nightmare. So there were definitely some sacrifices made to make this change, but talk about what your brokerage looked like before you moved over.
Okay, so that's the beauty of it. So when I had the conversation with Michael and Jay, I had 50 agents here with me. And Michael and I were talking after the meeting. He's like, you know, not all 50 of them are going to be happy about this. And you're going to have some haters and people are going to be talking about you. And some are going to be closed-minded, and you're going to have to be strong enough to get through this. It's going to be tough, can be. And I said, you know, I know that. And I'm an enabler. I'm a people pleaser. I don't like people to be upset with me. Never. I always want to find a way to make them happy. You know, I'll take the weight of the world on my shoulders just to make your day better. And I've been like that my whole life. And so, but when I had that meeting with him, I said, you know, I can't focus on that. What I have to focus on is where real estate is going. Because number one, as an independent broker owner, when I built this office, I had to do a build out. You know, I have a fortune invested in here, a lot of money that we haven't been open long enough for me to even recoup that yet. So this is an investment for me. So I also have to protect that investment. And I'm no dummy. When you see an animal like eXp coming, I mean, it's like Uber. It's what Uber did to Yellow Cab. It's the same concept. So by aligning myself with eXp, I've protected my brokerage. I've protected my team. I've protected my agents. And so what happened was there were some haters. There were several, actually, and they did spread words, you know, that weren't true through the community. And I have a great reputation. My company does. And so it didn't make a lick of difference in the community. Everybody knows my heart and my soul. And so they didn't believe anything that they were hearing. What they heard was I got presented an amazing business opportunity for my company. And I chose to provide a better life for my family and for the agents that trust me. And they know I would never lead them down a path that would take them to anything that would hurt their business. So yeah, we lost a few, and that's okay. It's not for everyone, but the ones that we've lost, we've already replaced. So we still have the independent brokerage running. There's still some there, but for the most part, there's at least 21 of us now that have already moved over to eXp. We're migrating slowly because it's a transition. And you know, people have to rebrand and people, and so it's a migration process. But the beauty of it is that we basically at my company, we have in essence, we have two real estate companies under one roof, because I have, of course, the independent brokerage, it's a brick and mortar, and we are also an eXp branch office. So we have the best of both worlds right here. And so when I was at the conference, you know, when I opened my office, the chamber director, he said, if you said one thing, what was your goal for opening your business? And I said, I just want to dominate. That's what I told him. And it's on camera, it's on film and everything. So when we were at the conference in New Orleans and they put up that slide and they put up the picture of the world and it said 2020 world domination, I was there probably salivating. I'm like, oh my gosh. It was like lights and fireworks were going off. Cause I, at that moment, I mean, I knew before, but at that moment I was like, oh, I can, the picture was so clear. It's like total domination. And when you are where I am in the Houston market, I mean, word is spreading. We're touching people. We're reaching out. And I've told agents that aren't open to it yet. I'm like, maybe you aren't right now, but I'm going to tell you something. You're crazy if you don't get in on this with us now, because it's in its infancy. Come a year or two from now, shoot, it's going to be all over the place. You know, it's going to be put, we're going to be putting companies out of business. And I am so proud to be part of this, honestly. And you know what I did for my group and my team that came with me? We came as a group. And then I've also got about probably 11 or 12 that moved over as individuals because they want to form their own teams. Yeah. And so we have it in all different ways under EXP. But what I told them when we all moved over, and as we're all still moving over, I told them, A, thank you so much for believing in me and trusting me. Because you know what? I trust Michael and Jay. And that's why I said yes, because I trust them and I know them. I know their hearts and I know their integrity, and they would never, ever misguide me. And so my agents and my team have the same feelings for me. They know my heart. They know my soul. I would never, ever lead anybody down a path that wasn't going to make them a better person. And we feel the same way about homeowners. And so by getting under the EXP brokerage, it allows us to protect more homeowners, more agents, more people, touch more people's lives. And oh my gosh, that's what it's all about at the end of the day, you know?
I know exactly what you mean. So tell me this, from the moment you heard about EXP, how long did it take you to actually make the decision to move?
Almost a year.
Almost a year. So you and just so you know, I mean, I've talked to people that moved like within a couple of weeks, and then I've talked to people who moved who took 3 years to move. And so everybody's story is different. So, you know, what were you when you first heard about it, and you were immediately like me, and I, when I first heard about it, I was just not interested, right? I mean, we were In 2017, we were selling over 300 homes, and we were trucking right along, and we were the number one Keller Williams team in all of our city, in all of Dayton, and so we didn't have a reason to move, right? Or we thought we didn't have a reason to move, exactly. Right? But you know, I like you have been in that circle with Jay and Mike and Al, and there's another guy, Andrew Gaydosh, in our marketplace who's in that circle too. And so I've always been paying attention to that, right? And I'm looking at it and I'm seeing like these huge players, right? Like Jay and Mike and then Kyle Whistle and Dan Beard. Yeah. I mean the who's who of the Wall Street Journal's, you know, top 50 or top 10, I mean, for that matter. And they're all coming over to EXP, and I'm like, man, you know, maybe I ought to look into this, because am I missing something here? I mean, all the top real estate agents in the United States are moving, and then I started obviously to do my due diligence, and you know, here we are. But yeah, you know, I think the thing that I didn't expect, Tricia, that I'm so excited about is kind of what you alluded to before, is the collaboration between agents. Yeah. Because I that was never the reason why we moved. It's always just been kind of the cherry on top. And I have been, I mean, I had so much fun down in New Orleans, and
me too.
I mean, being able to talk to Brent Gove, I mean, and some of these like major, major players, man, and just hanging out and masterminding, and it has taken our business just to a whole new level. And we are so excited, especially now, to roll into 2019. How about you?
Oh my. It can't get here fast enough. And, you know, being in that conference in New Orleans and being surrounded by that many people fired up and that many people that are just, they're going places, they're doing things, they're spreading the word. It's so exciting. I was here in my office just yesterday, and I was having a conversation with somebody that's been in real estate for about 40 years. And he is was not interested, of course. And really, he had heard of EXP, but really didn't have an open mind to it because he's been in the business 40 years. You know, he's just not looking at that. But by the time our conversation was done, he was like, oh my gosh, just your energy alone in this conversation is something that I haven't experienced in so long. He's just doing that same old school routine, and he's just closed-minded, kind of was. He was in the beginning. So
you know what it feels like?
People that you talk to, it's like, wow.
It feels like, have you ever gotten your kids like the perfect Christmas gift or the perfect birthday gift? And like, you haven't, like, they haven't seen it yet. They don't know about it, but you know about it. And you're like, oh man, I can't wait till they open this. Yes. I can't wait till they see it. I can't wait. It's like every conversation is like that. And it's like, you know, you get out of bed every day excited. It's kind of reinvigorated me and what we're doing in just from a team perspective here.
Oh yeah. You know, everybody is resistant, or most everybody is resistant to change. Change is hard. I mean, of course change is hard. So when you're, you know, comfortable, people don't want to change. You know, if they're making what they consider a comfortable living, that's fine. They usually are the ones hardest to change. But if you really open your mind and have an open mind to something, have a conversation with somebody, because I'm going to tell you something. You should be part of this. The agents that are here with me and the groups that have moved with me, they are thanking me every single day. Yes, they push through change, and yes, it's a learning curve, but it's a learning curve to better yourself, to better your business. These agents that moved with me, they are fired up. They're like, oh my gosh, thank you so much for bringing this to us. Thank you for actually pushing through and fighting with that resistance. And they're fired up. And so when you see that kind of gratitude from people, that it just makes it all worthwhile. And then you know that 2019 is going to be so much better for them. They're going to hit bigger numbers, greater numbers, and that y'all all did it together. And you were the link to them having that kind of life. I mean, it doesn't get any better than that, you know?
Doesn't get any better. Yep. So I'm curious for you, like, when you're running, because I know that there are some brokers, some team leaders that will listen to this, and they're thinking, you know, how does someone like Tricia that is running a brokerage and also a team, how do you approach those people and have that conversation? Is that in a group setting? Is it individually? Are you just talking to your leaders?
It's better individually, definitely phone conversations. I've had a lot of phone conversations, and then I invite them to the office. The office here is beautiful. It's classy. Everybody that comes in, that's their first thing they say is, wow, you have a really nice office. They come in, they see the energy. They feel the energy is what they do. They feel the energy in here. And I'm very transparent. I mean, nothing in my life is scripted. Whenever I do public speaking, I don't even rehearse it. It's me. It's real. It's raw. I believe that's how life should be. So I don't ever have a conversation with somebody where I'm trying to make something up or show them something crazy that's not real. It's real. I mean, I would never have moved my company had it not been so real, so good, and so amazing. So I think when you see that kind of passion and you see that person's true spirit in it, how can you not be attracted to that? And if you really want to better yourself and have a better life and provide a better life for the agents that, you know, you're responsible for, or that look up to you, or that you mentor, how can you not want to give them everything? I mean, it's just like you said, it's like your kids. You want to give your kids everything, you know? And so when you're trying to guide your kids and you know the path that they should go on, and they're teenagers and they're so resistant, they're not listening to you, they're hard-headed, but you keep pushing on because you know, this is, look, I'm trying to show you the right way. Stop being so hard-headed. It's the same thing with agents. It's like, look, I'm not trying to take anything from you. I'm trying to help you. Would you just listen and look at this? And I think it's really just pushing through that brick wall of people's minds sometimes. And oh my goodness, the more people that are open-minded to this, I can't wait to see where this goes. I know where it's going to go. I just can't wait to see it. I'm so grateful to be a part of it. And I can't wait to see what the next 2 to 5 years are like. I mean, honestly, I see world domination. Yeah. No questions asked.
Open-minded is the key word there. You know what I mean? It's I think that, you know, if you'll just have an open mind to what else is out there, and maybe it's not just EXP, maybe you should explore all of your opportunities and then be able to make a decision about where you want to spend your future. I'm curious to hear your answer on this, though, because, you know, why do you think people stay at traditional brokerages where they're paying, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60% of their commission into the broker, and the narrative from the broker is, well, we're giving them training, and you know, we have a great name in the community. It's like, why aren't people figuring that out? Like, why are people willing to pay in so much money? And some of these companies, Tricia, they don't even have a cap, right? You're just consistently paying in money and there's no end in sight. And then some of them have a cap and it may be, you know, $50,000 or something like that. Why do people stay at those places?
That blows my mind. That blows my mind. And, you know, before I had the EXP conversation, when I was just running my independent brokerage here, and I was talking to agents all the time, and they would come in here and tell me, you know, I'm paying a 60-40 split. And I'm like, what? Why? What are they giving you? And they would sit there for a minute, like speechless, and say, you know, I don't know. I don't know. And I honestly think people just somehow, a friend of a friend of a friend, somebody lures them into that. And then I don't know if they're afraid to leave that. They don't know where to go. They don't know how to go off on their own. But it's like, you guys got to open your mind and you've got to think of your future, because look at what you're paying your broker and what are you getting? Actually, look at it. If you're on an 80-20 split, wherever you may be, 60-40 split, whatever it is, what are you paying at the end of the day? What are you getting for that? I would love to hear that. Is it your signs? Is it your business cards? Because really, I mean, I'll give you $500 a year to come over here and I'll pay for your signs and business cards all day long. But really, you need to think about your future. You should be part of a company that A, you can be an owner of, and you can have a say, and you can create great things and take this company to places nobody has ever done. EXP is in all, you know, we're nationwide now in every single state. You know that? Remember, they announced it at the conference and it was like, holy crap.
West Virginia was the last one.
Part of that, you know?
Yep. West Virginia was the last one. We are now in all states. One other thing I want to add to that too is you said it perfectly when you said what are you getting for that money that you're paying in? Because you're making as an agent, you're making that money, and you know, and then you're paying it in, and you really need to take inventory, especially as the market tightens up, of what you're paying for. Like, people, really, you need to investigate what you're paying for. And what I mean by that is, you know, if your broker is saying they're providing training, well, what is the quality of the training that they're providing? And, right. You know, like our Keller Williams office always touted training, right? But there was no one in our office that was producing more than we were. So we were limited to the amount of training that we would even want to attend because of the level of quality. And now, you know, when you have training, when 5 days a week and it's all cloud-based training, right? And I can show up in my socks and underwear if I need to and have Brent Gove teach a class, or Kyle Whistle, or Dan Beer. These are people that are doing, you know, $200 million in real estate. And what, I mean, so that's what I would say to you know, to those people who really take inventory of what you're paying for. And if the narrative is training, right? How good is the training? And is that worth the amount of money that you're paying? Because
Let me add a note on that now that you're talking about that. Okay, so, you know, coaching has become a big thing in the last 2 to 3 years, a really big thing. So a lot of these big box companies, not only are they taking a split, 70-30, 80-20, whatever it is, well, now we'll throw in coaching too. But that's another 10%. You know, that's not free. So it's an 80-20 split, but if you want coaching after you go through your training, whatever, then it's another 10%. Now, the beauty of EXP, it's like you have, like you just said, you're being trained by top mega producers across the United States. Good Lord, who does not want to get that training? And there's no extra. It's still an 80-20 split, 16 cap. Who does not want that? Like I've told everybody, it's basically like free coaching, but it's coaching from the best of the best of the best. It's not some hourly person at a market center, you know, training you because they've never done real estate. They've never sold and actually practiced real estate. They're just in there as a wage earner. So when you get actually trained by top producers who know the systems, the processes, the tools, and have done it and implemented it, how do you not want to just copy them, model what they're doing, and copy it, you know? Who doesn't want to be part of that? That's where my biggest is like, what is wrong with y'all? I don't get it. I'll never get it. And so for me, who hated the split always, because I, like I said, we work way too hard to give our money away. This is not like that, you guys. It isn't giving our money away. It's an investment in yourself. It's an investment in your family. It's an investment in your life. If you are not attracted to making a better life for yourself, making real estate better, you should be ashamed of yourself, because everybody that's in our industry should focus on making our industry better, making it more professional, and being the best that you can possibly be for your family, for your agents, and for yourself.
Mic drop. Mike, that was beautiful. So, you know, we'll wrap this up now, but I love your passion. I love your passion for your business. I love your passion for EXP.
Oh, yeah.
I'm curious. I think that when people listen to the show, that there are going to be a lot of people that that identify with you and that align with you. How do people connect with you if they want to have a conversation about growing their business or talk about EXP or anything else for that matter?
My contact info is everywhere. Of course, you can go to the website, TrishaTurnerProperties.com. You can email me, Tricia, it's spelled T-R-I-C-I-A, at TrishaTurnerProperties.com. You can call me, 832-563-0916. I answer my phone all the time. Or look me up on Facebook, private message me for sure. I mean, I am here to be a resource for people all the time, for homeowners, for agents, whoever, brokers, owners, whoever. Because you know what? The more people that see this, the more people that get involved in this, like I tell the agents here, we need to be out there protecting the homeowners, because these homeowners are being misguided by unprofessional real estate agents. They call themselves professionals. They're not. And until you become part of an organization that's focused on being professional, focused on training, and focused on making this a better industry, we're not going to be better. And you know what? EXP is going to change that, because like I said, it's an army of people that are out there to make a difference. And I love it. And I am so grateful to be part of this.
Love it. Oh my goodness. This has been a lot of fun, and I could probably talk to you for another hour or so.
I know.
And maybe we'll have to get back together again. I so appreciate you taking a couple minutes out of your day, because I know you guys are busy selling hundreds of houses and setting the world on fire. But Trisha, thank you so much for being
here. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. Bye. Don't be a stranger, okay?
Yeah, sounds good. Thanks.
All right, bye.
Bye.
Dude, you killed it.